Him up just taking his signs down. Do you want to leave this dark in here?
You can take it down.
Okay, here's the opportunity. I'm going to set him all up. I'm going to take the sections one and two down the same length. Then I'm going to go back and take section one down a little bit. And we're going to leave his top four. I'm going to set him up with the two blade. Come here. Sections one and two stopping just below the crest of the head. For you all's benefit, I'm going to just watch the guard so y'all can. This is a three guard. We set it up with the size initially. This is a three guard, but I got it all the way open, so it's basically three and a half. And I'm just going. Change to the two guard. And I'm going to adjust it all the way open, leave it all the way open, actually. So again, two and a half is the setting. And now I'm starting to blend in that first weight line. It's not all the way gone yet because we have to go back to the blade we used to set it in. And using our blend stroke to actually take it out. But we're gradually getting that line out and going less into that transition section than we did with that three and a half. Reduce it to the two guard size, and now we're taking that line all the way up. And I'm just right on that line, and I'm using my blend stroke. I'm moving pretty fast, but actually, this is what I'm doing. I'm rolling it off the head like that. Cutting stroke is straight up into the line, blend stroke is rolling off the line. See it with the naked eye, but if you reference the mirror, you can see that line pretty good. It allows you to go in there and see it and hit it a couple more times. And I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna use the blade sizes, the sizes that you all have, so you can see exactly how these blades work. Shadow fade is anything between triple off and the one blade. I'm gonna set his up with a triple off. The reason why I'm gonna use the triple off on his is because his texture is nice and dark and rich, but it allows us to be able to see a nice difference between the two sections, the sections one and section two. And I'm gonna fade his pretty low around the ear. I'm just fading his real low here, setting them up. And I'm going to drop down pretty low in the back, around the nape. Point where we're just setting up any fade. Setting up any low fade. Or shadow fade. Yeah. This first weight line, everything below this first weight line is section number one. First weight line is the most important line of a fade because everything else is based or referenced off of this weight line. We want to make sure it's straight. We want to make sure it's balanced. It doesn't necessarily have to be straight in the sense that you're just making a straight line, but you want to make sure on either side of it, as you work your way around, and you don't have any dips and uneven parts of the line. We'll make sure that it's balanced on the over the top of the ear. It's balanced on either side. since I already basically blended his sections 2 and 3 in, almost not all the way complete, but I made 2 down. I want section 2 left around that length, so I'm just going to set my transition line in there. And the transition section only goes into the intersection number 2 about a half inch. So I'm going to go above that first weight line we made about a half inch all the way around. Above that first weight line. Notice the width of it is based off that first weight line. That's where the importance of that line comes in at again. That first weight line we make, everything else is kind of measured off of that line. Again, I set his number 1 section up with a triple off. I went to the 1A in order to put that transition section in there. Section number 2 is cut down to a 2 blade. So now I'm going to tie all those 3 in together. Drop down to the 1 blade. I'm going to start taking that first weight line out. Using my blend stroke now. I'm not using cutting stroke because we're no longer setting lines. We're taking lines out. So now I'm using my blend stroke. Blend stroke is a circular motion. But that line is not always not going to be all the way gone yet. Why? Because what blade do we have to use in order to take the line all the way out? Y'all know?
What's that right there?
This is the one blade.
So go down one?
Yeah, so what blade am I going to have to use in order to take this first weight line all the way out?
Three out.
And using what stroke?
Blend.
The blend stroke, exactly. The same blade that we use to set that line in is the blade size that we're going to have to use to take that line out. But we're using a different stroke. We use a cutting stroke to set the line, use a blend stroke to blend the line. But we have steps that we have to go through in order to get back to that blade side. We can't just go right in and set the line with a 3 out and then take the line out with that same blade. We have to go through the steps. I'm not going to take the line all the way out yet because I always like to leave myself a little space in my blend in order to make sure everything is as tight as possible. So I'm going to go up a blade size and I'm going to start working on the second weight line. This dark line right here, going to the number 2 section. So I'm going to take my 1.5, now I'm blending up. I'm fading my way up. Now we can see the blends are coming in. Now we're going to go back to those exact blade sizes again. I'm going to go to the 1A first, take this top line all the way out, using my blend stroke. We're not raising it, we're just hitting it right on that line and lifting the clipper up off of it. Takes practice. I see what they're doing. It takes practice. It's almost like you're chopping, but I'm hardly touching his head. I'm just resting the clipper on there and just rolling the clip off. But I'm conscious of where I have to go, how high the clipper has to go up into the hair. Because I can see my lines. I can see the lines that I set in there. You want to make sure those lines are definite made. You don't want to fade as you go. You want to set lines in and then go back and take those lines out. That's what makes the haircut uniform. It takes practice, consistency. That's why I gave you that chart. That chart will tell you